Well, hello, everybody. Welcome into yet another DaVinci Resolve tutorial. My name is Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com, and today we're going to break down nodes, the what, why, when, where, how, who, the five W's of journalism, as I've recently learned. We're going to learn all about nodes. That's what I'm trying to say. We're going to have a bunch of fun while we do it. Let's jump into DaVinci Resolve and check this thing out right now. Alrighty, here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and I want to talk about nodes. Nodes are, they're just an essential part of DaVinci Resolve. You can see them up here. These are your nodes right here. We only have one node. It's just our first shot that we've brought in. Nodes are kind of like what Photoshop layers are. They allow you to layer on effect after effect after effect. I like to use one node kind of for any little thing I'm going to do. So really, anytime I want to make some kind of change to my footage, I think I need to add a node. In this particular shot, what I want to do is add a vignette. I want to change the blue to more of a tealish green color, and then I want to change his pants to orange. We're going to use a series of nodes in order to do this. So let's begin with the vignette first. Now, in order to create a vignette, we're first going to throw a mask onto this node. So I'm going to use this window here. You can think of it like a mask. And I'm going to click the circular mask. And then I'm just going to drag it out nice and wide. And then I'll make it a bit taller too. And then down here on softness, I'll hover over that. And I'll just increase softness. You can see here for our nodes, we get a little preview of what exactly is taking place on that sort of layer. So I can see here exactly what my mask is revealing. Now that's the exact opposite of what I want. I want that nice soft edge, but I want to select the bits on the outside. So I can hit this little button right here. This is going to invert my mask. You can see now we're just selecting the stuff on the outside. Now note, it doesn't punch a hole in my footage. It still knows that all the footage should be there. It just knows that whatever effect that is going to be carried with this node is just going to attack those areas that we've selected. Now I'll come over here to my curves. I'll simply darken up that area. You can see how we're creating this vignette. Not too strong, but you know, we still want it to be noticeable. Maybe I'll spike the whites a little bit and just drag the white point down a little bit to flatten out those dark areas. Now, once you have a node, you can do a number of things with it. Number one, you can drag it and move it around. I can select any one of these connecting lines and delete those lines. But the problem with that is, then you can see our footage returns to normal, because what we've got here is this little green tab. This is sort of the footage coming in from our editing area or our media delivery section into this editing bay where we're going to do all of our color editing. So I want to make sure I drag a line out of that and say, yeah, link my footage to this first effect. But you can see still it's not showing me anything because I need to also link my footage to the output. So this is sort of the footage as it's being shipped out and ready for delivery. So I want to just make sure I link that as well. So you always want to make sure that you've connected all of your nodes. Sometimes if you right click and choose add a new node, these basic serial nodes is what they're considered. Here they're called correctors, which might be a little confusing because I just told you they're serial nodes. But here for some reason we call them correctors. We're going to add a corrector, and you can see that there's nothing here on this corrector. In fact, it's not even in amongst our footage. It's just showing us this gray. If you create a node this way, which there's a much easier way to create them, I'm going to show you in a second, you can always drag it, and when you see the little plus icon, boom, add it, and it's going to be added within the context of your node graph. Now, I don't want to use this, so I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to choose Delete Node, and you can see it just snaps me back as I wish. And, as you may well imagine, you read your node graph from left to right. So over here is kind of our first effect that's going to happen, and if I add more nodes, they're going to kind of pile out to the right. Now, I don't know if you noticed right there when I right-clicked and chose Add Node, there are a bunch of different nodes, parallel and layer and key mixers, splitters and combiners. I'm not going to get into all of those here. This is just a very basic, just how do I think about nodes? How do I use nodes? There's some really cool stuff you can do with some of this stuff, but that we can save for another tutorial. For now, we've created our vignette, and what I want to do is create a new node, but I'm going to use my super special hotkey, which is not super special. Everyone's got it. It's Option S. That would be Alt S on the PC. It just throws a new node in there. It's beautifully lined up. It looks nice and straight, and it's all connected the way we need it to be. Now, just another aside, see this orange outline around the node? That's the selected node. If we want to get back to the vignette for any reason, double-click it, you'll reselect that, and you can see we can come in here and say, you know what, I actually want to lift the black point to make that vignette really low contrast in the shadows. I don't want to do that, but I'm just showing you, giving you an example. You can also hit Command or Control D to temporarily disable that node, or you can press the name of the node, which is just this number, right? So it just temporarily disables that node. And you can also move nodes around. So if we decide we want this node to come first, we can do that, but you can see these lines get all mixed up and muddled up. It's kind of a pain in the neck, but what you would do, just kind of the quick and dirty way, is select all of these lines and start deleting them, and then move the number two around, and you would reconnect it and, you know, basically drag all these lines together. I'm just going to undo a bunch of times though, because I don't want to do that. I want my vignette to come first. And the next thing I'm going to do is do my color treatment. We've spent enough time talking about the node graph, haven't we? Let's get on to some color correcting. So I'm going to double click here on number two, and I want to basically select the bluish area and change it to more of a teal green. So here in my curves, I'm going to come over here, and I don't want hue versus luminance. I want the hue versus hue. And I'm going to click right around here to add a point. And I'm going to click right out here to add a point. And now in here, I'm going to be affecting everything from like the teals to the heading into the magenta range. And if I push up, you can see we're getting all that color green. If I pull down, we're getting more of a purple into like a red territory. I want to push this up into like the greens. And then I'm going to come over here to hue versus saturation. We're going to roughly target the same area. And what I'll do here is I think I'm going to pull down on the saturation a little bit. Just kind of something like that. And again, here's an area where we might want to just preview this. Command or Control D, there's before, there's after. We've changed the color of our background there just like that. Something else I should mention about the node graph is a graph, not graph, it is a graph. You can zoom in on your node graph and take a closer look or zoom out if you've got things going on all over the place. And if you realize your node graph is a huge mess, you can right click in an empty area and you can choose clean up node graph. And it'll just give you a nice evenly spaced area, which I'm going to promptly mess up. But you know, if things are a real mess, that can be a nice way to quickly go in and clean things up for you. Now I want to add yet another node. I'm going to hit Option S. That'll be Alt S on the PC. And the goal is going to be to target his little pants here and change the color of them. You can see because of the way we're changing the background color, we're getting a bit of a fringe around the pants. Again, this isn't meant to be perfect. We're just kind of having some fun here. So the color change of the pants isn't going to be perfect, but I still think we can do a pretty decent job. So I do have node number 3 selected. You can see the little orange border around it. I'm going to select the eyedropper here, which is going to allow me to set what's called a qualifier. Basically, it's going to say, look, just apply whatever effect we're about to apply to stuff that's similar to the color and hue and saturation brightness values found in his pants. Now, we can always spread and change where the color is, the width of the color. So, you know what? Take into account more of these yellow and orange tones, and we can soften that to sort of allow it to be gently influenced by the colors around. I think I will increase the saturation value, and I will change the fade on both ends of this as well. And also, I think I will extend to allow it to select more in terms of the brights and darks, and I will also soften this up as well. There we go, something like that. Now, we can't see anything. We can see up here on our node, we've selected something that's looking rather pant-ish. But until we begin really shifting the colors and whatnot, it's going to be difficult to see what we've done. Now, we could go back to curves and adjust the colors there, but I think I'm going to try coming over here and hitting the number 2 and adjusting the temperature. If I crank the temperature up, what do I get? You can see that the pants are getting noticeably more orange. If I hit Command or Control D to shut that off, the pants look almost completely desaturated. So we're getting very orange pants. I may try to boost the shadow, see what that looks like. Yeah, I think that kind of looks cool, something like that. And what I may need to do is come back to the node before it and try just settling down some of these colors, kind of reining these in a little bit, something like this. Let me rein these in just so I'm not completely cranking the color that's wrapping around the pant legs and see if that can help our pants look a little bit nicer. I'm going to come back to node number 3 here. Let's go back to our qualifier. Let's extend the saturation, see if that can help us at all. You can see here, it's helping a little bit, but not as much as I would like. Maybe I'll try lowering the shadow amount and boost the highlight amount here so we can really just extend what we're getting. So again, it's not perfect, but we're getting a decent job, or we're doing a decent job getting it. And you can see as I cycle through the footage, it is doing a nice job of tracking it. The problem is we're also catching some stuff on his face and making that quite orange as well. So let's apply a mask as well to this node. This is why nodes are super valuable, because we can isolate the pants and this effect just for the pants up on this node all by itself. But that's not enough, because obviously we are getting a little bit of the skin on his face that is turning orange. So let's add a mask here as well. I think I'm just going to go with a normal square, and I'm going to begin kind of at his waist level because he just walks straight forward. And I'm going to extend out to the side here, and then I'll extend down to the front. Whoop, I want to extend down to the front this way. And then I will just increase the softness kind of on all sides here just to make a nice soft transition, something like that. And what this is doing is it's saying, yeah, first use our qualifier to select all the orange stuff, but then, oh, by the way, only select the orange stuff that's going to be within this little mask square that we're using. And you're going to see now his face is back to its normal color, and the pants always stay within that masked area, so we never have to worry about them getting messed up. So this is really the power of the nodes. We were able to build out this effect and quickly change the way this footage looks. Now, I can hit this little slash icon up here. This is going to shut off all. See that? Bypass all grades. That's basically going to cancel out all the nodes. Not cancel them out, but just get us to the point where it's like, here was the footage right when you brought it into DaVinci, and if I cut the bypass, we're going to see exactly what we've done. Now, maybe you get to this point, you realize I've completely fouled this up. You can come up to color and you can do a number of things. You can reset the selected node's grade, and that just takes the selected node like this, If I go back and choose reset it, it's going to reset it to exactly the way it was, which in this case is going to get rid of our vignette. I'm going to undo that. You can also go reset grades, but keep the nodes. This is going to undo all of our work, but keep those three nodes, right? Also, not really what we want to do. And the final option is just getting rid of the entire thing, reset all grades and nodes, which just takes us back to where we were with one node. So that is the very basics of working with nodes in DaVinci Resolve. That's a good way to think about them. There's a whole lot more you can do with them. Don't be fooled into thinking this is all you can do with nodes. There is so much you can do with them because it is a foundational element of color grading and color correction here in DaVinci Resolve, the oh-so-powerful node. And there you have it. That covers the basics of nodes. There's a lot more time that could be spent talking about nodes, how they work, what they are, when you should use them, and give examples of all that stuff. But if you did enjoy this tutorial on the basics of nodes and how you can get started using them today, make sure you subscribe to this channel so you never miss any other video editing tutorials in the future. Also, make sure you follow me on Instagram. And if Discord is more your thing, you can check us out over at discord.me/tutvid, where the conversation continues on and on beyond the end of this video. And for checking out nodes, particularly serial nodes and previewing and shutting them off and layering on effects and color grades and just everything that you do with nodes here in DaVinci Resolve. Guys, for this one, that's it. Get it, got it, good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.